we came here because of the fight between inside our country, and we cannot live there and no longer. That's why we move here. And then if they send it back, it will happen the same. Not the same situation will happen, and we need to go outside the country again and again. So we are a little bit upset with the NGO because they get wrong with us. They think that we just want to get opportunity, we just want to get life guarantee or something like that, but it's not right. We have been sacrificed for this baby whole life. So like she will be 7 years old, and then we have been sacrificed for 11 years. So for the next baby, we cannot survive any, we cannot sacrifice anymore. Like we need to find a new life, and we want to get a new life.
Thank you so much to the US government for funding. This has been very helpful. Hello.
Yes.
Sir. So, you are Karen.
Yes, I'm Karen. Yes, sir.
So, what would you like to say to the people, to the Karen in the world, and to the world?
We want to peace.
Yes. When he said that we want to get peace and fairness. Like we need to be fair with other people. Yes. We Karen have been pressed by Burmese people, so we want to get peace. Yes, not just right now, it's over a long time ago. And also Burmese government, they said that we will make all the Karen people disappear, not just only a few of them, all people, all the whole ethnic to disappear.
Not even inside the baby. Understand?
Morning, I go to Mela camp to see my friends. Oh, morning.
Thank you, Alain. sapitiyo vivacchantu sapparo ko vinasatu mate apavangvandarayo sukhete kayuko apavapivatanasire sanicca buddha pacayino jataro
One more. Ah, Bibi. Ah. Thank you. So this morning I go to Melakam to meet my friends, Christina and San. Peace Sunday. The situation is really, really bad in the camp. She's going to explain you. Oh. Calmer là.
Okay.
Not okay.
Okay.
So he is here. So we go together to Mela camp.
Yeah.
To see Christian and family.
Yes, that would be nice. Let's get inside. She wants to show us a house.
Yeah. You've never seen their house?
No.
Yeah, he's never been to the camp.
Wonderful people.
Yes, wonderful people. So terrible situation.
Yeah. A lot of the world could be put right if people would just be a little kinder.
Yeah. Here we are in Mela camp. Thank you very much for welcoming us again.
Yes. A dramaturgy for students.
Yes. Of your school.
And many schools.
Of many schools. Okay.
Yeah. People who not live here.
18335.
Your home?
Yes, my new
home. The new home?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh.
All right, mister. Ah. All right. Wow, beautiful.
Chicago.
Oh. Aung San, Christine, Peace and Day family, new house.
HN338.
HN338. What is your first impression here?
The hill. The hill. I don't want the hill. You can keep it. Too old for hills. Everybody wants to take me to monasteries up there and waterfall up there and view up there. YouTube. I don't come in no more, I watch YouTube. Save my legs and my chest.
Thanks to YouTube that you're here.
Yeah. Oh, it's good.
Where's the school?
Hello, morning.
Morning, Christine.
Nice
to see you again. Well, again, I want to try this.
Yeah.
Beautiful. So many students will arrive little by little, yes?
Yes.
For eating.
Yes. Students, also neighbors, also people around us.
So your school offers this?
Yes.
So great, so kind. So many things to eat.
These are my group.
Your group?
Yes. Hola,
gay.
We sell frying noodles and vermicelli.
Nice drawing.
I draw by myself.
Really?
Yes.
Beautiful. Hey, hello.
Hello.
Yeah,
I'm Noel from ESCC. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. So you're a teacher?
Yeah, and for your gift for the school. For the
school. You're welcome. It's very small, yes. But next time I can give more.
Okay. Thank you.
Our school teach English and computer, only two subjects, and these are very very old, and we no use. We
not
no
yours,
longer
yeah.
use the, those. Yeah.
Mm.
That's why, because we live in a schoolhouse, not our own house.
Ah, right.
So we put things, the school things, under our houses.
So here, on the same building?
Yes.
There's another teacher here?
Yes.
He has very little space. He's alone?
Yes, alone.
Yeah, okay. So this is your house?
Yes, my house.
And baby playing computer?
Yeah. Playing on the phone.
So this is one of the rooms.
In the past, students lived there.
Student
lived
there.
Okay.
Near the top of the mountain as well.
I'm very poor, so the only thing I can give is my bag with a few things in it.
Yeah, yeah.
There is some bandage. Which can be used, there are a lot, because many Mexican countries, they are very good quality, different kinds.
Thank
they
you.
Can be used for for you, for anyone.
Yes.
The best quality, very expensive.
Thank you.
It was donation from someone.
We can use it for our students because they always play football.
Yes.
And they can use.
Yes. They can keep on the knee, on the side, on the arm for 3 days.
Yes.
3 days. Okay. And also have some dynamo lamp for you.
Thank you.
Thank you. A small one for Bibi.
Thank you.
And also Sola. Yeah. One for Angsan, Mr. Angsan.
Yeah, thank you.
And inside also some few things, like other dressings, you know, different kinds. This is smaller. Good morning, Christine.
Morning. I'm very nice to meet you again.
Me too.
I'm happy that you give your time and you come to us and you see our situation. We really want to show our situation. Right now, situation is not changing, but our house is changing right now. And then I stay working at the same school. Yes. The situation inside the camp is not stay changing and even get worse because of NGOs here, NGOs that support us inside the camp with education or with healthcare or something like that. They will stop. They said that they will stop support the healthcare and education. Also, our school has the same problem. We have a lot of students and only a few teachers. We have only 9 computers for 84 students. So it's not enough. But we try our best to run our school. We all teachers and principal work together. And we also heard that all the organization, they currently invite us to go to the meeting, but the meeting is always about going back to Myanmar. They force us, they force us to go back to Myanmar. It's not by our wish, not by ourselves, but they make us think that we are we accept what they request. They said that, now, do you have any future plan? And do you already have future plan like that? But we didn't think that they asked for that to go back to Myanmar. We think that, oh, they want to know our future. And we said that we have no future, but we will stay inside the camp as long as the camp is here. And we are not so sure about where to go or where to live. But we hope that one day we can go to a place that is safe for us and safe for our new generations.
Because current state is not safe for you?
No, it's not.
Why?
Because they are still fighting inside current state.
Yes.
And even the same current army fighting each other, like BGF, DKBA, like that. I also heard that some people from Nobo and Ompian camp, they said that past 3 months ago, BGF soldier, they came and collect the porter, but they just let people know that we need some help. We need some help and we'll give you some money. And then we Karen are very honest, and we think that, oh, we will get some money, so we will work.
The BGF did this?
Yes, but we didn't know. We didn't know that they did this. We think that, oh, that would be good for us, or we can get some money. And then some people from Ompian and Nobo, they go and work for the BGF. And then later, the maybe a camp leader find us about that, and then they have an argument between the BGF and camp leader because they didn't let the camp leader know about the situation, and they just come and tell the community that we were workers, we will give you some money, just like that. Yeah. We also heard that that will be happening inside our camp, our Mela camp, and then we are all afraid that it would happen to us. We are so worried that the BGF we also come to in our Mela, people are very afraid of them. Yes.
So they are very close now.
No.
Near the border.
No. We heard that.
You heard this? Yes.
Yeah, we heard that the same thing will happen inside Mela also. So every people here they are so afraid that we will be taken by soldiers. Right now, Russian also we have less Russian. If we have five family member in a family, we also have only for four, and we didn't have for one because they reduced the rations. But they said that the sponsor also cannot support for a lot of people. They just support for what they can, as much as they can. And that's why people here, they need to find some money to get enough food for them. But some of them don't have education, so they cannot work with the NGO or education system here. They need to work outside. They need to go outside. Same as the lady, the old lady.
Yes.
Yeah, she is in terrible situation right now because the person who she live with, her sister, cannot work inside the camp because she has no education. So she goes outside the camp and work outside the camp as a daily worker, like planting crops. Yes, planting crops and harvest the crops like that. Though she needs to follow with her sister. So she is now outside the camp, and we heard that she is very ill and she cannot survive. But we cannot look for her. We asked the neighbors, and our neighbor said that we are not so sure about that. We know that they go outside, and then where did they go? We don't know. They said like that. So it's very difficult for us because some people would like to help her and contact with her, with us, but we could not find her. It's a big difficulties for us also.
And manager.
Yes. Right now, our situation is very bad because we have some hopes and some future that we want to have. Most of the people inside the camp, they really want to stand on their feet because right now we need to lay on the NGO, but they just support us to survive, not enough. So we need to get enough food or enough shelter and then roofed like that. So we would like to walk outside, or we would like to work somewhere else that we could get more money, or we would like to go to that country like America or Australia so that we can earn more money and we can survive and we can live by ourselves. We really want to do that, but we would like to people around us to know our voice. We need to tell them that we want to do, but we are not, I am not sure that why they are afraid of to tell the right, to get their own rights, to tell the people, to tell the NGO, to tell the people who support it, so that they could hear us and then maybe they can help us in some way, or they will let us to stay inside the inside Thai to get a Thai citizen or something like that, or they can let us go to that country to get a new life. And it is very also important for our new generation. We have been living inside the camp for 11 years. Some people have lived inside the camp more than us. They have born inside the camp and they have nothing about outside the camp. They have no education, they have no point of view about the world, so it's really important for them to get their own rights and to get the good opportunity, not just enough to survive, to get to like we want to stand on our feet. We need to, we want to hold our own money, like the money that we earn, like that, yes. Yes, we know that the NGOs they treat us like we came inside the camp to go to that country. No, they didn't know our problems where we have faced inside Myanmar. They didn't know. They just think that people around inside the camp, they want to have a chance to go to that country. That's all. And then they tell all the NGOs that we support inside the camp, they said, oh, they want to have opportunity to go to Australia, to go to America, like that. But it's not right. The information that they give around the world is not right, because we came here because of the fight between inside our country, and we cannot live there and no longer. That's why we move here. And then if they send it back, it will happen the same. Not the same situation will happen, and we need to go outside the country again and again. So we are a little bit upset with the NGO because they get wrong with us. They think that we just want to get opportunity, we just want to get a life guarantee or something like that, but it's not right. And some organization, especially who help Karen, they told the sponsor who support camp, they said that you don't need to support because people have enough, and then they came here that they just want to go to Australia. They just want to go to America. They want to be an American citizen. That's why they came here. They are useless. You cannot, you don't need to help them. They can survive by themselves. They tell like that. So people inside the camp, some people, like most of the people didn't know about that. Didn't know that organization inside the camp tell lies to the NGOs or sponsor who supports us. Yes. Yes. And even UNHCR workers who was in UNHCR and also NGOs, they built and building that they help the people who would like to return to Myanmar. They build a building at Zongsi, and people who want to go back to Myanmar can talk with them and can ask them for a suggestion, or can they will give them somehow when they go back to Myanmar, like that. But that is one bad thing for us, because they have built the building, so it looks like that we need to, we must, we have to go back to Myanmar. Like, if we need any help, they can help us anything. And they also have a UNHCR inside Myanmar. They said like that, whenever we go and ask for a situation, like we want to know the situation, what will happen next, or what about the Thai authorities, what do they think about us? We have been living inside the camp. Do we have any opportunity? Do we have any chance to survive by ourselves? But whenever we go to the office, to the UNHCR office, they just said, they just suggest us to go back to Myanmar, and they said that situation is getting better. You can have more job opportunity. You can have free school, free education system, or something like that. They persuade us to go back to Myanmar. Yes. The organization that I mentioned are CBO, Camp-Based Organization, KRC, Karen Refugee Care, and UNHCR. They work together. The three organizations work together, and they force us. They just tell the situation is better in Myanmar. You need to go back. Whenever they come in the camp, when they talk with the people inside the camp, they said that you should go back. The situation is changing. No, you have more opportunity like that. So it's like very, we feel very bad. Because even our current organization, KRC, who take care of us, want us to go back to Myanmar also, is very bad for us. Because we know the true situation, but they just tell us lies that we should go back, we should live there. Because it is our homeland, like that. So we feel very bad for that, for all of the information that they give us.
Yes, I was in January in Kalung State with the Free Burma Rangers for 10 days, in December and January. And see, people have nothing there in Kalung State. People are just, they have no health care. They have no school, they have nothing. Only dirt. No real road. They just walk on path between villages to get some eye care. The woman had to walk very long, many hours, because she knew that the American eye medic was here, and she was one of the lucky women because she could walk.
Yes.
And many others cannot. And many other are in villages which are never visited by anyone. No NGO goes there. Even the FBI, I'm sure, they don't go there because they're so too isolated. And the Burmese did not prepare for you.
Yeah.
For your well-being, for your situation. Yes. Yeah.
That's why I would like to tell that it's not possible. We cannot go back to Myanmar because
yes.
we have. Even though they have prepared the land, maybe they will take the land in some days and then we could do nothing.
Yeah.
We live here, even though we have a little healthcare, a little education, but it's better than inside the camp. Because inside Myanmar, most of the people inside the camp are Karen. So if we have to go back, we need to go back to Karen state. But Karen state is very dangerous for us right now. Like you said, no education, no healthcare. So we are so worried about our new generation. Yeah, it will be very terrible for them, because children are very. Children can be a good leader one day, to lead the people. So they should have good education, or they should know about the right for their right. So. It's not possible for us to go back to Myanmar. We are not accept their ideas or their support, anything. Yeah.
Some our leader, like KMU, KRC, and don't believe them. Because they do themselves, not ourselves.
Yes, they just do for themselves. They didn't do for us. They just do the thing that they can get a higher position or something like that. Some of the leaders from KNU and KRC, they just think for themselves. They are only a few people. We are a lot of people. They need to think for a lot of people, but they just think for themselves for only a few people. We have been fighting for 60 years to get our current state, but we think that it's like meaningless because a lot of people have been suffering. A lot of people are in difficulty. But there is no good way that we just stay fight for to get our current state like that. So I think they should stop and they should protect their people. They should not give their people troubles. Yeah, it looks like they give us troubles and they want us to in a difficult situation like that. Yes. Now, I would like to talk about my family. Now, we have a new baby right now, and we are so worried about the new baby because we have less ration, and I don't think that we can survive for four people. And we don't want to die inside the camp. we want to go outside the camp, or we want to go to some place that that we be safe for us.
I don't want my generation like me, so I want to work.
Yes, you're strong. You are very able. You can do a lot of things.
Yeah.
You are good. You are serious always. Very serious person. Every time I met you, very stable, always the same. You respect other people. You're very humble. You don't criticize uselessly other people. You watch. You love. Your family deserves some real future. I really dream that someone was kind of influenced, listens to you, and helps you.
Yes, we also want that too. We also want someone who can help us, or someone who will fight for us to get a chance to go to some place that is guaranteed, that has guarantee for us, for our family, and for our babies.
To guarantee life for me and my new generation.
And your family, just
yes,
your family.
My,
yes, your family,
my family,
yeah.
My family.
So if there is anyone who would like to help us to get a chance to go to somewhere that is safe for us, you can help us as much as you can, and we really would like to want some help for any people who could help us with, who could help our family, and who could help our generation. We live inside the camp for a long time, it's like meaningless, so we want to get better life than inside the camp.
I pray that your voice will be listened. That people will not just watch the video and comment, oh, it's interesting, it's good. And I'm so sad for these people. I'm sad for my kind people. But if you're abroad, if you're in the US, you're Karen, you're so safe. If you spend very small percentage of your salary to help the Karen people in Mela camp, it just, if for them it's a huge sum.
Yeah, we don't want to survive with somebody help. Like, we don't want to survive with, like, someone give us some money to survive. We don't want that. We want to have our own money, and we want to help back people who need help like that. So if we cannot do like that, it's like our life is meaningless, because we should help each other like that. Yeah. Right now we cannot help some people because we also accept help from other people like that. So our goal is, we would like to stand on our feet, and we will help back people who need our help. Not even Karen, any people who want our help. Right now, we are really despair, like we are very disappointed with ourselves, with life inside the camp. We want to escape from the life, from that kind of life. We want to get a new life. Yes. Thank you.
Yes.
Last 3 weeks ago, 17 Rohingya family members get a UN register. They arrived in refugee camp just one or two years ago.
Yes.
We live in refugee over 10 years, 11 years ago. We cannot get registered.
Yes.
But the gap. Why?
Why? Yes.
I went to Earth, Yuan.
Yes.
Why?
Yes. Why? This is incredible. What happens there, which is shown by all the media, I don't not judge what is happening there. What I say is that the focus is there, and the Karen are completely forgotten by the media, by the politicians. You don't listen, you don't hear anything about the fate of the Karen. You don't hear anything.
I don't hate Rohingya people. They are also human. But the UN war is not fair for the same refugee.
Yeah, we should get fair.
Yes, fair, yes. Fairness.
Yes, fairness.
Yes.
Yeah. If they give the Rohingya UN registration, we also should get UN registration because we live longer than.
Yes.
Yes. So we don't understand why we cannot get, and why people are focused on Rohingya, not just only Rohingya, not other people. So we would like to ask them that why they just focus on the Rohingya. They should focus on some other people who are also in difficulty, who are in trouble.
Yes.
Yeah, 3 men inside the camp with Rohingya people or Karen people. We have the same 3 men, but they have special opportunity that they get the UN registration so that they can apply for that country. And it is safe for them. I mean, it is safe for them as soon as they get the UN registration.
Yes.
But for us, it's not safe. And it's like, it's not fair for us. Yes.
People arrive 1 or 2 years ago, get registered. We live very long.
Yeah,
we cannot get.
We don't understand that why KRC did nothing for us, because they stand for our Karen people, like they are Karen refugee care. So they should know about the information that Rohingya get the UN registration. I think they should fight for our Karen people also. They should think for us. They should tell the UNHCR that you should give to our Karen also UN registration. They should stand in front of us. Like they should protect us, but right now we don't understand the why they didn't protect us or why they didn't work for us. I think we think that they work for some people from Burma, like that. Yeah. I just want only one thing, that if we have a chance to work, if we have a chance to get our own money, we can raise our children to stand on their feet to get their own life, not to lay on some other people. Yes, so I just want one thing, that I want to work on my own. I want to get my own money. Yes, to support my children and my family. Yes. Huh? Muda?
Thank you so much to the US government for funding. That's just been very helpful. Hello.
Yes.
Sir. So, you are Karen.
Yes, I'm Karen.
Yes, and you've been here for 20 years.
Something.
20 years.
Over 10 years.
Yes. Okay. You've been here over 10 years.
Yes, sir.
So what would you like to say to the people, to the Karen in the world and to the world?
We want to peace.
Yes. When he said that we want to get peace and fairness. Like we need to be fair with other people. We Karen have been pressed by Burmese people, so we want to get peace. Yes, not just right now, it's over a long time ago. And also Burmese government, they said that we will make all the Karen people disappear, not just only a few of them, all people, all the whole ethnic to disappear.
Not even inside the baby.
Baby inside.
Understand? Okay. So, dangaroma feel it. Can I just see it?
So we have that kind of feeling that we don't like that they will make us disappear. They will make our current ethnic disappear. Yes. They technically did that to our Korean people's day right now.
About children?
No, about children. They want to make us disappear, so they make us to be in difficulty, to run away from our homeland like that. Yes. Burmese education system is always changing, but
four-year one-time changes.
Yes. They didn't want educated person to rule them, to take over them. So they just control the education system, and they just send the people that they want to control the country. They didn't want the educated person to control the country. Because future generation are the leaders
of our country, our nation. No.
The reason why we came inside the camp is because of the country situation. The country situation is not good for the people, so we leave the country and we move to the camp. If there is no war or there is no civil war, it will not be refugees. If a country is developed, the citizen will not go to other countries to work there. We will work inside the country. But if the country is not developed, that's why we go to other places and to work there. And in Myanmar, we don't have a rule for the basic salary, so people cannot work inside Myanmar. Yes. If they have a basic salary, it would be good for the people inside Myanmar.
And for the Karen, it's even harder than for the main Myanmar people.
Yes.
Because they have no status.
Yes, no status, yes.
Tablu, God bless you.
Tablu, God bless. Amen.
Amen.
Glad to see you.
Glad to see you too.
Yes.
So Ian, what is your last word in the camp?
In the camp? It's downhill going.
And but what else? What else?
Well, I like the camp. I like the people here. The conditions could be improved, but I don't know how. Really, the best way of fixing the conditions is to empty the camp, let people go places where they can have a home. It's not right. It's like a country within a country. You know, it's too vast, too big. You know, you drive down the road here, and it's kilometres. You're driving down the camp, it's kilometres. So, you know, it's just I don't know. Something has to be done. The big people are not doing it, so I don't know what can. You know, there just has to be something to do.
I'm very glad to meet you, and I hope that one day we will meet again at your home.
Me too, Christine. You're welcome. You're my honored guest. Yes. I hope you can get immigration visa for Europe.
Yes, I hope to. Anywhere is okay with us, not Burma. If anyone who would like to help us, I would like to request you that could you please ask the Thai authority to give us a chance for a UN registration so that we can apply for a resettlement in that country. So if you could help us, you could email to the Thai authorities, or you should tell them that we our family to get a chance to resettle and to get a registration UN identity card. Because if we don't have this, they encourage us to go back to Myanmar. If we arrive at Myanmar, we don't have any registration, we don't have any identity, and it will be very difficult for us to go outside or to work. That's why we need the UN registration to apply for a resettlement.
Yes.
If we have to go back to Myanmar, they give a place to live, but we don't have identity card, so we cannot go outside our house. We cannot walk outside our house. We just have to stay inside the house that they give us. Yes.
So you cannot travel, you're not free. No. So it's the same as here, you're
yes,
prisoner.
The same as here, yes.
Yes.
Maybe worse than here.
Yes, worse than here because you're not farmer.
Yes.
You're not, you never lived as a farmer.
Yes.
And it's not possible for you. Yes.
Yes, it's not yes. possible. We have been sacrificed for this baby whole life. So like she will be 7 years old. And then we have been sacrificed for 11 years. So for the next baby, we cannot survive any. We cannot sacrifice anymore. Then we need to find a new life, and we want to get a new life.